Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome back to Mad Medicine. In this video, we are going to be discussing separation anxiety. Now, as always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel if you guys like what we're doing. And let's begin. Let's talk about separation anxiety. It is a normal stage of development for infants and toddlers, and usually a lot of infants and toddlers will grow out of this stage around 3 years old. Now, of course, this is an average. A child might have separation anxiety longer than, 3 years. They might be done with the separation anxiety earlier, but on average, you should know that around three years, a child grows out of their separation anxiety. That's really, really important, because if you can understand the normal, then when it gets presented to you in an abnormal fashion, either in the clinic or in a board question, you'll be able to figure out what it's talking about, what type of disorder it is. So 3 years old, separation anxiety should be done. Now, it is diagnosed, separation anxiety itself is diagnosed when the symptoms are excessive for the developmental age and it causes significant distress in their daily functioning. So what this means is that, let's say you have a child who's older than 3 years and they're presenting with symptoms of separation anxiety. They're afraid to leave or afraid to disassociate themselves with their parents. Well, you can definitely see how this is excessive for the developmental age. This shouldn't be happening normally, as well as the fact that if it's restricting their daily function, if it's making them not go to school, stuff like that, then you can also see how this is becoming a problem, and it could also be diagnosed as a disorder. So that's definitely something you need to keep in the back of your mind when it comes to diagnosing someone with separation anxiety disorder. Now, this is a childhood anxiety disorder, so keep that in your mind as well. So when it comes to the disorder itself, it occurs when there's distress when a child is separating from their home or their parents. A lot of times we think that separation anxiety only happens when a child disassociates themselves from their parents, but it can also happen when they disassociate themselves from their home. And that is because these two things right here are where the child feels the safest. Okay, and because the child feels the safest in these two areas, it's really difficult for the child to leave those safe zones, whether it's their home or whether it's the company of their parent, and they don't feel comfortable leaving that area to begin with. They start to have separation anxiety. Now, this may classically present with a child who's older than 3 years old, and usually it's around 6 or 7 years old in a board's question, who presents because the parents say that the child is refusing to leave the home, they refuse to go to school, and they refuse to leave the comfort of their parents, or the proximity of their parents. That's a classic presentation of separation anxiety disorder. They start worrying about losing their major attachment figures, which could be either the home or the parents, and they're persistently reluctant and refuse to go outside. They don't want to leave the house, they don't want to leave their parents. Again, it's very very simple. Now, they may have an overwhelming fear of separation, but this fear has to last at greater than or equal to 4 weeks. And this is really important because this is a diagnostic criteria. So let's just write important. Don't forget this. Anything that's red, obviously, is important, as you can tell. So it has to last greater than 4 weeks. The symptoms of their anxiety, of their refusal to separate, have to last at least 6 weeks. 4 weeks, sorry. Now, clinical symptoms include having nightmares about the separation, repeated complaints of physical symptoms like headaches, upset stomach, or nausea. Now, usually this might happen because they don't want to go to school, right? It may seem like a child doesn't want to go to school, but it might be separation anxiety. So let's just write that. Don't want to go to school. Now, keep in mind, you are going to have to distinguish between the separation anxiety being intrinsic or extrinsic, these physical symptoms being intrinsic or extrinsic. So if a child doesn't want to go to school because he or she doesn't feel comfortable at the school, then you need to differentiate whether it's happening extrinsically. If a child's being bullied or if they're dealing with something else at their school, that may also cause them to complain that they have headaches, they have upset stomach, they don't feel good. But if they just don't want to leave the house, if they don't want to leave their parents, if they don't feel comfortable, if they get anxious when they leave, then definitely these physical symptoms are a sign of the separation anxiety disorder rather than being something extrinsic. This could be fictitious, just to avoid going to school, like we said. And the treatment is very simple. It's usually cognitive behavioral therapy, play therapy, and family therapy. It's done in a way so the child feels comfortable leaving their safe zone, so that they don't have, you know, a fear of separating themselves from either the home or the parents. The goal is to pretty much teach the child about coping skills and how they can get through this, you know, difficult period when they do separate. And between the cognitive behavioral therapy, play, and family therapy, usually this is a very treatable disorder, and a child can grow out of it if it's treated properly. And with that being said, thank you so much for watching. As always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. When you do, don't forget to hit that bell notification button and go on to the next video.